Sleeve gastrectomy is a newer operation which fits somewhere in between adjustable banding and gastric bypass. It has advantages over banding in that it causes better, more predictable weight loss than adjustable banding, and advantages over gastric bypass wherein it avoids some of the vitamin and mineral problems as well as some of the intestinal problems or ulcer problems that can develop after gastric bypass. The weight loss is about 60% of excess weight, and it's about the same level of risk as far as the surgery itself as a gastric bypass, maybe a little bit less. In sleeve gastrectomy, we take the stomach, which is shaped sort of like a bag, and convert it to a tube or sleeve-like structure where we cut away this portion or 3/4 of the stomach, leaving just a tube of stomach to carry the food down to the intestine. So food will enter the esophagus here, enter into the tube of stomach, and then directly to the intestine. One of the interesting things about sleeve gastrectomy is it's not just a weight loss operation that works by restriction or by limiting volume, but it appears that this portion of the stomach creates a hormone that stimulates hunger. And by removing this segment of the stomach, by removing this portion, the hunger is controlled or dramatically lessened. So this operation works in two ways, adjusting the amount of food that you can take and also your response to the food or the hunger level that you might feel. So in a sleeve gastrectomy operation, there's usually 5 incisions made, small ones laparoscopically. And in that operation, we free up what's called the greater curve of the stomach, or the longer side of the stomach, by dividing a bunch of blood vessels here, and then staple the stomach across this way to remove this portion of the stomach. About 75 or 80% of the stomach is removed, leaving just the tube of stomach. And that's done with staples that staple off and attach the front and back walls of the stomach to each other to create this tube. Once that piece of stomach is removed, it can't be given back, obviously, but once it's removed, the operation is completed. Sleeve gastrectomy is an increasingly popular choice for weight loss surgery. It holds a place somewhere between adjustable banding as far as risk and gastric bypass as far as weight loss. So we see a risk level that's lower than bypass and weight loss that's better than banding. It also has the advantage of less vitamin and mineral malabsorption issues than gastric bypass and absence of a plastic or foreign body around your stomach that can slip into the wrong position as with banding. So it's increasingly popular. Patients really have an easy time eating after a sleeve gastrectomy for the most part, and it doesn't have the associated vomiting or dumping syndrome as you see with band or bypass. For this reason, more and more patients are choosing sleeve and fewer are choosing banding especially and bypass unless they're really looking for extreme weight loss or have diabetes. As with any of the weight loss operations, sleeve gastrectomy is appropriate for patients with a body mass index of 35 to 40 associated with medical problems, or 40 or above even in the absence of medical problems. As far as specific operation to choose for one of those patients, sleeve is probably appropriate for a wide variety of patients. It's fairly low risk, fairly low complication rate long term, and predictable weight loss makes it the choice for many patients. Your recovery from sleeve gastrectomy probably will involve 1, sometimes 2 days in the hospital, and 2, sometimes 3 weeks at home before going back to full activity at work. Most people are up and around the day after surgery, and most people are doing fairly normal activities by 2 weeks.